We're also just getting some information about a new witness who's agreed to testify publicly in front of the January 6th Select Committee. What can you tell us?
Yeah, and it's a significant one, Wolf. CNN learning that Sarah Matthews, who's the former deputy press secretary in the Trump administration, was there on January 6th and then resigned shortly after because of she was upset with the way the former president and his staff handled January 6th, has agreed to testify publicly at an upcoming hearing. Now, we don't expect it to be a part of next Tuesday's hearing, which was just announced a few minutes ago by the committee. That hearing will focus on domestic extremism and white nationalism and its ties to the Trump White House. Sarah Matthews could be involved more in a hearing that focuses on Trump's lack of attention to what was happening on January 6th. She, of course, is among the former Trump White House allies who have rushed to the defense of Cassidy Hutchinson, the star witness that we saw at the last hearing.
Congressman Comstock, expanding or bringing us back here to Washington, we expect to hear from Sarah Matthews. I mean, you've been in Republican politics a long time. Sarah Matthews, if we hear from her, there was a pretty interesting tweet from her that I think we can show everyone that she put up about Cassidy Hutchinson, essentially saying that Cassidy Hutchinson was brave and that anybody downplaying her role is trying to discredit her because they're scared. There are a lot of young women stepping up here. What does it say to you that Sarah Matthews may be the next witness?
Well, I think you've seen with this committee, the women are leading from Liz Cheney. I also would like to point out that Adam Kinzinger has, too, as a Republican, people who are doing this to a great threat. And he's getting threats against his family. But I think Cassidy Hutchinson's testimony was very impressive. And now you're going to have someone who is in the middle of the press office, worked with Kayleigh McEnany, was her deputy, who probably on that day, in the days leading into that, was all in the middle of this. Remember, we have all those texts from Mark Meadows back and forth to Fox News when Sean Hannity saying, hey, the counsel's office is going to quit. You can't do this. Sean Hannity and Kayleigh McEnany were talking and texting during that time. Well, probably I would imagine Sarah Maxwell, in addition to being able to confirm a lot of the information that Cassidy Hutchinson testified to, is going to be able to give additional information about what was going on in a lot of detail. And I think this is coming together very well and very seriously, because I know when I was in my previous life, I was a counsel on a committee, we did do referrals. And the documentation that we got sometimes was a little ahead of the Justice Department, but it was and sometimes different from what the Justice Department got. But now you're seeing the Justice Department also pick up the ball, and they're doing things, and it's coming together well, and it's not going to just be he said or she said. It's going to be a lot of documentary records, and MVP goes to Mark Meadows, who in real time you see all of those texts that went on that confirm really what these women are saying.
Text from Mark Meadows, it's like the name of a bad play or something like that.
Sarah Matthews, who is a former deputy press secretary, spoke to the January 6th committee. We've seen a little of her testimony, but she's now agreed, according to two sources, to testify at an upcoming hearing. What questions is the committee going to have for her, do you think?
I think it's going to be, number one, state of mind about what was happening, what she observed with former President Trump. I do think the committee is using her to bolster Cassidy Hutchinson, the other former aide who we saw testify and who has come under pretty intense attacks from people around former President Trump, questioning specific pieces of her testimony and trying to raise questions about her credibility. So I think that's a big piece of the goal here.
Who is Sarah Matthews?
She's a former deputy press secretary. I mean, she was not, you know, a senior aide. She was somebody, however, the junior aides in all of Washington, and you know this and you know this, see a lot, right? So, I mean, she was in a bunch of rooms. She was aware of a number of things that were going on. Exactly what the committee is hoping to get from her, I think we have to see. But I do think that a big piece of it is this is supposed to bolster what they got from Cassidy Hutchinson.
Yeah, and she and others knew that it was a very bad idea when Trump sent that text about Mike Pence. They knew the right thing to do for the president at that point was to tamp things down, and he did the exact opposite.
Yeah, two people that we've been highlighting over in our Magic Wall segments every day, I'm proud to say, for weeks now have been Cassidy Hutchinson and Sarah Matthews. Cassidy Hutchinson, of course, was an enormously important witness. The most important thing we've seen, we've only gotten a glimpse of Sarah Matthews' testimony, she talks about being inside the White House as the riot was happening, and she said something to the effect of, we all realized that the president had to tamp this down. Next thing we know, we look at our phones, 224 notification, Donald Trump sends the Mike Pence tweet. So I think we're going to get an inside view.
And look, it's another live witness who was a White House staffer who can corroborate perhaps Cassidy Hutchinson, who may have stories of her own from what she literally saw during that day.